battle of the sexes has been waging for decades, including on the tennis court.
Hello?
Eureka, Billie Jean!
It's Bobby Riggs. Listen, I had a great idea.
Male chauvinist pig versus hairy-legged feminist. No offense.
You're still a feminist, right?
I'm a tennis player who happens to be a woman.
Don't hang up.
By the way, I shave my legs.
I am not saying that women don't belong on the court. Who would pick up the balls otherwise?
Oh, my God.
You know what I'm doing? I'm cooking. I'm cooking!
Now, Billie Jean King beat Bobby Riggs in that 1973 match, and now an Aussie doctor and author says he has the proof that women are superior to men. Let's talk to Dr. Ricky Arneson in Perth. Doctor, you're an endocrinologist, so the science is settled then. How are women superior?
Well, the book describes that in great detail, but if you want two simple answers to that, the one is that we all know that men have one-track minds, whereas women seem able to think about many diverse things. So unfortunately, in the intelligence stakes, since men are usually distracted by their one-track minds and women are concerned with the welfare of their families and many other important world issues, there we have one point to the women on that one. But as well as that, one of the things that the book explores is that human survival depends on women being genetically designed to nurture and breastfeed infants, which makes them nurturing and kind by nature. So the book is all about celebrating the magic of wives and mothers, which most of us have in our lives, and we recognize how magical their qualities are.
There we go. I like the way you put that. Yeah, we're all different. Let's just work together here, folks. you're having fun with this new book, though, right? But there is some serious advice there, like when couples fight and what they can do to reduce conflict, because that's most important.
Absolutely. So the title of the book is somewhat tongue-in-cheek, although I do admit that I'm a great admirer of women, and this book is a celebration of great female qualities. But at the same time, one of my purposes of writing the book was to discuss the common reasons why couples fight and also to give resolutions to that. And that was really one of my inspirations for writing the book, is that I was always fascinated by the fact that most of my friends all fight about the same issues in their marriage, and the men and women bring all the same complaints. So the book explores why that's so, because understanding why men and women behave in certain ways can lead to better understanding. And of course, finding resolutions for that and creating happy marriages and happy relationships is something really important.
Oh, I love this. Now, why can't... I have a very specific question. Why can't men find things in cupboards?
Yes, so that's a common problem, isn't it, that wives send their husbands to find things and then the husband can't find it and then the wife gets super cross when she finds it in 10 seconds. And there are scientific reasons for that, and that is that men are primarily originally genetically designed to be protectors and hunters. So they tend to be very unifocused in the way that they look at the world. So they're very focused on a single task. So if they open a fridge and look for an object in it, they have a very specific image in their minds as to what they're looking for. And they also have poorer peripheral vision than women. So if they look in the fridge and the object in front of them is slightly different to what they're seeing in their minds, like the package is a different color or it's behind something, they just can't see it. And of course, their wives come and find it in 1 second, and they usually get a smack across the back of the head for that.
Yeah. Sounds like every time we go to Westfields, in fairness. You never have a problem when I can't find the chocolate, though. And the thing about men, all right? Tell me about it. They seem very insensitive to their partner's needs. We don't mess around the house all the time, don't we? Why is that? Why do we do that?
Well, one of the real focuses in the book is trying to turn a man into a human and become a worthy partner for his wife or partner, because ultimately we all love our partners and we want the best for them. So if women live in this modern pressured world where often they're two working parents, where people are under pressure, and men really do need to pull their weight, because we don't have the liberty of the bygone eras where, you know, men came home from work at 6 and sort of sat on the couch and watched TV. But there are also, again, reasons for that. And what I said in the book is that men are mission machines and women are care machines. So men tend to be very focused on mission rather than necessarily more diverse emotional perception that women are. And that's also based on the way the brain works physiologically in men to enable the survival needs of the human species. And in saying that, the book is very much focused on how we make the most of that, because it doesn't promote the idea that there should be gender roles. The book promotes the opposite, that men need to step up and take care of their wives properly and pull their equal weight at home. And it's all about focusing on what makes both partners happy.
Oh, great stuff. And that's it. It's all about compromise, isn't it? Dr. Ricky Aronson, your book is called Women Are Superior to Men. Thank you so much for joining us today. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me.
Accept that one?
No, I thought that was great.
Oh, great. We all have to work together, don't we? Communication, folks, communication.